Hey, you see that? That's our first international arrest in Canada. Oh, you see that? That's our arrest in our 42nd state in Delaware. YouTube's censoring channels like this left and right. If you want to keep this movement alive, consider joining Locals in the pinned comment. You can see all of these uncensored, no filter, for only $7 a month. And you can keep this movement alive and spite big tech. Choice is yours. You can support the group that hasn't arrested 42 different states in 2 countries. You can see catches like the fire lieutenant, which I can't post publicly until after his trial. You can see all of Stinghouse content that I think is too spicy for here, plus much, much more. Contribute directly to getting these people off the streets. Keep yourself entertained. Keep us going. Join Locals. Pin comment. What's up, guys? Before this video starts, be sure to follow us on all platforms, including on Rumble, which you can find in the pinned comment. This platform has been giving a lot of people like us a lot of problems lately, and Rumble is a lot more receptive to free speech and whatnot. So be sure to follow us on Rumble. Any video on here, you can also find on Rumble. And if you're looking for a video and can't find it on here, it'll be on our Rumble. So be sure to follow us on Rumble in the pinned comment. Like the video. What's up, guys? A lot of you guys may know about the Gordon Flowers hoodie. However, we also have a Fried Pickles hoodie, as you can see right here, and Gordon Flowers sweatshirts that you can get in many, many different colors. Show your support for the Gordon Flowers movement and the PP movement by getting one of these. I can tell you, they are very, very comfortable. Like, in all seriousness, they are. And I actually do wear them, so be sure to get one of these and enjoy the video. This channel is a group of investigative journalists who make educational documentaries showcasing and educating society, especially parents and legal guardians, about potential scenarios that result from young people and adults conversating online if left unchecked. We conduct thorough interviews with consenting adults in an attempt to understand their perspective on why they partake in these conversations online with people that are not of age. The goal of the interviews in these videos and the videos themselves is to gain an understanding of the perspective of the individual being interviewed, so parents and the rest of society can be educated and aware of potential thought processes and desires of adults online to unsupervised persons not of age. These videos are not to cyberbully, harass, degrade, accuse, or threaten any individuals partaking in the interview process or in the video itself. We do not condone any of these actions. These videos are strictly educational, and we grant full permission for academia, which is any classroom setting, or in scholarly papers, to show or cite our videos. To ensure that these videos are strictly used for educational purposes, we strictly adhere to YouTube's community guidelines, such as not revealing someone's personally identifiable information, in other words, PII. YouTube defines personally identifiable information as their home address, email addresses, signing credentials, phone numbers, passport number, medical records, or bank account information. We thoroughly look at and edit our videos to ensure that none of this information about any individual is shown in our videos. To ensure extra privacy for each person that is a subject of an interview in any of our videos, as of September 1st, 2022, to thoroughly comply with YouTube's harassment and bullying policy, there will be no mention or information about the last name or first name of any person interviewed in our videos. Due to potentially illegal activities discussed in our videos, law enforcement in the respective jurisdiction we conduct these interviews in is notified of each interview and video filmed by us. We are not accusing any individual interviewed of being guilty or committing a crime. That is the job of law enforcement. We are not vigilantes, and we do not condone vigilantism or vigilante behavior, such as taking the law into your own hand or not notifying law enforcement when a suspected crime takes place. We are investigative journalists. Trigger warning. Some of what can be discussed in these videos can be sensitive to some, emotional, or stressful. The only goal of these videos is to educate the public. At the end of each video, as of September 1st, 2022, there will be an educational portion at the end to discuss what was talked about in the video and to discuss what people can take from that video and learn from and tell others about. Our goal here is to bring awareness and educate the public. Now the video will start.
How's it going?
Hello.
Is there a Shane here?
That would be him.
Oh, how's it going? A package for you.
Package?
Yeah.
That's unusual.
Good. My name is Gordon. Yeah, it's about Emily that I got to talk to you about.
Yep.
Oh, well, Emily on Facebook.
And what's going on?
I'm just going to kind of talk to you about these messages here to her, if that's cool. Where's the best place to have it?
It's on Facebook.
Say again.
Who?
Oh, there's this girl I was messaging him on Facebook that, do you want to tell her? I mean, I just want to keep it between us.
Okay, what was going on? I'm sorry. Come on, you can tell her.
Are you Shane?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't know what's going on because I don't know. It's all I can.
What's the profile on Facebook?
Is it with
Can
a dog
I see the
in
profile
it?
Picture? Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's a hacked account.
Yeah, Shane, I just got to talk to you, man, about it.
What's the profile picture? Right. I can show you if he has access to it or not.
Well, Shane, the thing is...
No, I understand what you're going at, but is it... I'm telling you, it's hacked.
Yeah, no, I don't doubt it's been hacked before, but, you know, look, let's just be real, bro. Come on, let's just go outside and talk about it. You can know we're attacked all you want. Let's just go outside and talk about it. I'm not here to f*** you over with your relationship, bro. I'm sure we get this addressed and be done.
Okay, is it with... I don't understand why it's going on. Like, is it with a young girl or something? Because I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't bring that up. You did, so come on.
I don't Let's know. Just... That's my problem.
Yeah. Okay.
That's why I want to clarify.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, Shane, look. Is it cool if she just kind of stays out of it? Because
I'm his wife.
That's why I'm
okay.
Like, concerned. Is it because of a low girl or something? Because I don't mess mm-hmm. with that.
Well, I'm not saying you do, but this could be a one-off. You got carried away. I don't know. Because this is a girl who's 11 years old. Okay. So mm-hmm. Shane, the reason I know that maybe you got carried away or drunk is because Mr. Hackerman couldn't have sent this. Okay, and it's right here.
Right here.
Mm-hmm. Right here.
Oh my God.
So.
So wait. Also be my phone got hacked too.
Shane, we just want to talk about it, bro. Okay, it's not the end of the world, all right? And it's not that big of a deal. It's just internet shit. It's not like you met anybody, okay?
Okay.
Just take a deep breath. I know it's hard to talk about, especially with her right here.
Oh, it's not that. I'm scared because I don't know who would do stuff like this.
I don't even know who you're talking about.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's his account, not, you know?
I know. He tells me about anybody he texts.
That's my problem.
Well, it's a obviously wouldn't tell you about this one.
I just want to see the profile picture for the profile.
Oh, well, this is the one with the dog, yeah.
Okay, and who's the girl that...
I don't think he even used
Well, it's Emily. Yeah, Shane, we know you have multiple Facebooks. I mean, that's not hard to find out.
Right, but I only use one. That's my problem.
Well, I mean, Shane, the thing is, these messages weren't terrible. It's just, I got to just figure out why, because they were on the way to not, maybe not looking so good, but I mean, if we can nip it in the bud now, I mean.
I would like
he
that.
He could block her right now.
Yeah.
Or can you go ahead and block her?
Yeah. Go get your phone. Where
okay.
Is it on the nightstand?
Yes.
Okay. I'll go get it.
Okay. Can you show me that you block her?
Yeah. If you want to stay right there.
I'm not going to come in until you let me in.
I mean, I will log into there and just block her.
So, delete the account, too.
And I will delete that account, just to let you know. If you want to see...
Well, here, just show me that you block her real quick.
Okay. Because I don't understand what's going on, and I'm concerned. I mean, I do have access, but at the same time, I'm like...
Okay.
I don't understand why it's, you know... So you can see what's going on.
No, Don't go to Messenger.
Mm-hmm.
You're blocking her on Messenger. Let me see.
See, I know I have multiple accounts. I keep track of those multiple accounts just to
okay.
let you know.
So, Shane, you do have access to that.
Yes, but I don't understand why.
Give me.
It probably has been hacked. So, I'm...
All right. Well, look, man. I'm just going to be real here. You kind of tripped over yourself, and you said you can block her right now.
Yeah.
But earlier you said you had no access to it.
Because
so.
I thought I blocked everything and logged
okay.
everything out.
All right. But it's been a little bit since I'll message.
Right now. Emily.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but we still got to talk about what was sent because it wasn't just peaches and cream. Okay, is it cool if we come in?
That's why I was saying you can come
Thanks.
In.
Thanks. And just so everything's kosher here, I'm not here to make you famous or anything. Just because I trust both of you guys. I hope you all trust me. My name's Gordon. But in case anybody says I force myself in, I try to steal anything, I have to have it documented.
I see you have the mic, so you have recorded.
Yes, so everything can, so you can't say that I try to hurt you, mm-hmm. and then I can't go and say, not only did he say this, but he also tried to threaten me with
That's
a knife.
I looked and made sure I seen that.
Yeah, so everything's safe. All right.
Yeah.
I got two people, we have no weapons on us, okay?
Okay. What's the procedure here so I can understand?
I think we just sit down and talk about it. That's simple. Just be mindful of like don't get her on cam, okay? Like just be mindful. Or if you can, just you know, obviously. Is your name?
Yes.
That's fine.
I'm Gordon.
That's
like
wife.
I said, I'm his wife.
Messaging the wrong there, man. Nah, I'm just kidding. But
Do you want me to close the door? Yes, please.
Yes,
we got
the cat doesn't get out.
Okay. What's the procedure?
We're just confronting you about the mess in this apartment, actually. No, I'm just kidding. You gotta get that straight up, though.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
What's...
Okay. I'm just trying to understand, like, basically...
May I see the messages?
If you don't mind, if I can read them, then hand them to you after?
Absolutely.
Okay. So, y'all started messaging August... Is it cool if we turn on a light just so I can see better?
Yes, please.
There's not that much good light in here. This is the only light.
That's why I'm trying to understand what's going on before we all do anything.
Well, basically, I just want to understand, like, what happened with Emily, because you were so, like, cordial. It was so cordial at first. And I understand, like, messaging people on Facebook, looking out for them. Mm. And then just something happened, and...
I understand. That's where I'm like, I don't understand this. That's why. So, what's going on?
So, you and Emily started messaging in August, and she said, you said hi. I don't know if someone told you, but you're really cute, like a little sister type of cuteness.
Okay, I don't understand why that would be said. But you know,
that's what you tell me all the time.
Right, but what I'm saying is I would do
that's
that.
How you talk to people.
Okay, so can we just, look, man, let's...
Hey, don't get defensive, just listen.
I'm defensive because I don't understand why...
Just listen, okay?
My account was like that, that's why.
Well...
This happened back in August.
No, August to like a couple days ago, like... Yeah, I mean, come on. Okay, your own wife just said this. I mean, basically...
We just got married.
That's why I'm...
Oh, congrats.
Today.
Being defensive at the same time, in a way. Not trying to be...
Oh, no. I believe you.
Okay.
I've seen him texting other people before.
Okay. Well, if y'all are married today, let's just nip it in the bud now. Mm-hmm. I don't mean it to be a Dr. Phil, but I mean, if I was Dr. Phil, I would just say, let's nip it in the bud now, right?
You're deleting every spare account you have. Okay. Like you have been telling me you were going to do.
Okay.
So, I mean, basically, Shane, I can prove to you that you send these messages just on these messages alone, or we can just cut the BS and we can just fess up and say, hey, man, I sent these messages. Let's get it addressed so we can just finish this up and have a good marriage.
Okay, but at the same time, I'm wondering, am I going to get arrested because of these? Because I don't understand why.
Oh, I'll show you what's in my pocket.
Like, yeah, at least you know I'm trying to...
Just the phone. No, we're not cops, dude. That's why we came here. Because, look, I didn't know you were married. I know you had a fiance, a girlfriend. Congrats on the marriage, by the way, guys. Hope this is the best and worst day of it, you know. Just
we've had worse.
Okay, cool.
I hope this is the last of it.
Well, last of the bad days, right?
Yeah.
So
the last of all this.
That's what I'm saying.
Let's hope so. So
I'm guessing he said somewhere in there that he's in an open relationship.
No.
Good.
So, like, I mean, basically, like, I mean... No, we're not cops, okay? And I think the best thing to do, I mean, someone good, like, you're not some guy driving around the elementary school with an ice cream truck taking pictures. That's different than this, you know? This is just internet shit, it needs to be addressed, but it also, you know, there's levels to it, right? This can be nipped in the bud with this. Now, if you had kids in your basement, could that be nipped in the bud with a little talk? No. Probably not. So, yeah, that's why I just kind of want to come to you and just talk about... This right here. But again, I could, again, prove that you sent all these messages just by the messages alone, or we can just kind of...
Just nip it in the bud.
Okay. Did you send these messages?
I believe so.
You believe so, or did you do
it? Yes or no, babe?
Yes.
Okay.
But my only problem is, how can I send it when I don't...
You were on the account yesterday.
You literally just showed on your phone that you have the account. And when you told me I could block her right now, that's proof you could have access to the account, Shane.
Okay.
Again, I'll use the logic to prove you did it. I mean, okay?
Yeah.
So, you're like a little sister type of cuteness. And you mentioned that he says this to you, too. Okay.
No, he says this about other people. Like, hey, I think this person is a friend. And last time I believed him on that, I caught him cheating on me, so.
Well.
He's lucky I'm still here. And this... if it gets as where I think it's going to go... Our marriage might get annulled. So, please continue.
Yeah, I mean, dude, you got a woman right there who's sticking by you despite, from what it seems like, some stuff you could be improving on, man. So, I mean, let's, you know.
Telling people we were in an open relationship.
Was that the case?
No, okay. Never has been.
Okay.
All right. What do you do for work, by the way? Just curious.
Fast food.
Okay. Freddy's or where?
Wendy's.
So, right now.
Okay. Wendy's. So, ma'am, you are aware that him going to Wendy's isn't like a girl's house. It's just the fast food place. Okay.
I'm the one who takes him to work.
Oh, okay.
He doesn't have a car.
All right, well. Okay, so, and you are 28?
28, yeah.
Okay. And you said you're welcome and mine is 28. Is it okay if I may claim you as my little sis? Because this is when she said I'm 11. So, I mean, what happened, man? Why did the conversation continue? What were you?
I really don't know on that.
She just kind of get carried away?
I think so.
Okay. Was she just, I mean, I know it's hard to talk about with the real here, but like, was she just a cute girl to you? Is that what it was?
It's because I never had a little sister, that's why.
Okay, so it was like kind of filling a void?
Yeah.
Okay.
But on the other things, I don't know why it kept on going.
Like what other things?
I don't know why it happened, but there was other things that in that conversation, but...
Like?
Pics, stuff like that.
Okay, how many did you send pics to her?
Several. I lost
count. Wedding's getting annulled.
Okay. I mean, it started so cordial, like...
I should have just left it like that.
You shouldn't have messaged her. You shouldn't have added her. You knew nothing. You didn't know her. She wasn't you didn't have any mutual friends with her. I guarantee that.
So again, just so we clear this up, you mentioned you were from Missouri.
Mm-hmm.
And she said you were lying, and you said nope. And then you took a picture on Google Maps of your location, which shows you in basically northeast Kansas City. So that right there basically showed me that, okay, this is who you say you are. You're not, this isn't some hacker doing this for you. Because even, you know, say someone did get into your account, they could not do. That's a whole separate thing.
Yeah, you would need a VPN for that. A very good one.
Mm-hmm.
A paid one.
Then you said, yes, but I remember I don't have feelings for younger people like that, okay?
Mm-hmm. I'm just going to, because it's right there.
Yeah, you're good. So, I mean, what happened? It started with I don't have feelings of younger people. Then you're asking for pics of her.
I don't know what happened. I'm serious.
When did he start asking for pics? Was it around September?
Oh, yeah. Late August, September.
Yeah, that's around the time I caught him cheating. And that was on one account. I didn't even look through the other accounts. That was on his main account.
Hmm. So, there's a lot of double texting going on, too. Like, it wasn't just she'd respond once a day, you'd respond once a day. You would kind of ping her. Then there was a couple of months where, I mean, all of September, she didn't even talk to you. And then in October, you hit her up again. I mean, like, what... You know, I get it was a, you know, I understand the little sister void, but at some point this becomes obsessive, I think, you know. And again, hey, man, there's nothing wrong with that. I get it's internet stuff, okay? It's not as bad as it could be. So, I mean, look, bro, be frank. She already assumes the worst, okay, understandably. So all you doing explaining yourself, it can only make shit better, because right now she probably wants to kill you, okay? I wouldn't let her do that, but I mean, you know, I can't argue with those feelings that she has right now. So I mean,
he's been lying to me for months.
So look, you're quadruple texting this girl. If not, I don't even know the thing after quadruple.
Sextuple. That was the only thought they said.
Yeah, I don't know the 5-1 though. Whatever. Yeah,
maybe quintuple.
Quintuple. There we go. So, I mean, at that point, it's becoming like an obsession. Like that's how when I was, and I hate to use that word, but when I was a simp, that's what I would do to girls. That I would text. You know. Okay. Believe me, if it was like a, say, I don't know, a fat lady who used a mobile scooter to get through Walmart, I wouldn't be texting her like that. You know that. You know what I'm getting at here, right?
I do.
So, did you think Emily was some type of attractive to you? Couldn't have been, maybe not because of her age, but just physically attractive to you?
No.
Okay. Did you find her emotionally attractive?
I don't know. That's something I don't know.
Okay. Well, I'm just trying to figure out if this is like a pattern or if this is a one-off.
I think it's a one-off
right now. Okay.
You're going to prove it. To me.
Okay. So.
I'm going through your phone again.
So if this is a one-off, I mean, is this just the one time you found somebody underage attractive?
I don't know. That's something I don't know.
Okay. Well, I mean, you sent a video to her.
No, that's it. You're single.
We'll sort that out after this.
That's
okay.
What I was going to do.
We'll make sure it's sorted out. Don't worry. I can vouch for you, bro. Trust me. I've talked my way out of some shit with my girlfriend, too.
Have you guys seen the lanyard?
It's on the bed.
Thank you.
Do a little scavenger hunt for it and take a few hours in this house. Makes me feel good about my apartment.
I'm going to say friendly fire.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, my apartment's a mess, too.
I don't know.
Okay.
Probably because it's just also making you feel some type of way. I don't know.
Yeah. Was it maybe just her name being Emily?
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to hurt yourself, are you?
No, I'm going to my father's.
Okay. Dang. If you're sending someone with blue hair to actually go to their father, that's bad. Yeah. If you're sending daddy issues back to their father, you f***ed up. But we can address this. Holy shit.
It's
kind of
scary.
I've never seen someone with blue hair and tattoos say I'm going to my father's house.
I didn't even think that was possible.
No. All right. You can give me her number after this. I'm going to try to work it out for you guys, okay? If I can vouch for you, man, okay?
I don't know.
All right. Well,
I'll give it to you, but I don't know if she's going to be accepting at this point.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why all this happened. It was just...
I mean, do you think it was because of her... I mean, she's not here. Do you think it was because of relationship problems?
That too.
Okay, so you're just kind of looking for an outlet.
I think. I'm not sure.
So what better than another Emily, right?
I didn't expect that, if that makes sense.
Expect what?
Be a younger...
Right. It just kind of... You just kind of came across it. Okay.
It's... I don't know. And I didn't even mean to do that. That's the problem. You didn't do all that with...
Well, I mean, you meant to do it, but I mean, I don't think you wanted it to be that way.
No. Okay. I meant just to keep it cold, you know.
Uh-huh. Okay. So I mean, do you think, like, relationship troubles pushed you into just seeking this type of stuff out?
It was also just mentally from trauma, too, at the same time.
What trauma?
Trauma.
As a kid?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. So now that makes me kind of understand. So do you think maybe it was Emily's innocence that brought you to it?
I don't know.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I mean, look, man, at this point, you're at rock bottom, and being honest with yourself and being honest with us is just gonna make you climb up. Okay. So what do you think it was? It's something, obviously. Because I don't know, it doesn't last 7 months. You know that.
It's probably just through the, I don't know how to explain it.
Try your best, bro. Not here to oppose you, man. I'm here to get through this with you.
On a side question, if you don't mind, are you guys through a organization to help people like me? That's first thing like this?
Look, I don't think you need any trouble. I think you need help. So... let's get this addressed. But in order for us to basically get you that help and figure out, you know, because mm-hmm. I go to your house knowing that you sent pics to an 11-year-old. I'm like, do you have kids chained up? Is this a one? It could be anything, you know? Mm-hmm. So I'm trying to figure out what it really is. And, you know, obviously you weren't born like this. You were made like this through some type of trauma. So that gives me something more to work with.
I don't go to therapy because most therapy never helped. Me.
Okay.
It's forced. Feels like. That's
okay. So, anyway, back to what you were saying. That was hard to explain. Try your best, dude. We're here for you.
I think it is also due to what I went through, and I didn't know how to express it for one thing, so I think where it is, not just fester, and I didn't know where to, you know, let it out.
So basically, passing on the buck.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not on purpose.
No, I know you don't. I know you didn't wake up and just think like, yeah, I want to send this to an 11, but you kind of just, it kind of just became like, was it honestly like a misery loves company type of thing?
I don't know.
Okay. You think, or what do you,
like, I'm trying to,
mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, here, the floor is yours, man.
I think it is a miserable thing, because those months was kind of hard, because mm-hmm. I was in a rock bottom with her, and I didn't know how to express it, because I got no family up this way, hardly.
Okay.
I mean, I do, but they're over an hour away.
Right.
And I got no friends.
Well, that, I think a lot, I think you'd probably not be doing this if you had all those.
Right.
So, I mean, do you think that just being here kind of just left you in your deepest, darkest thoughts?
Pretty much.
Okay. So what is it about underage? Is it, do you think it's their innocence, or their, do you think they understand you better, or?
I don't know. That is something I've always been curious about.
When did these feelings start for you?
About doing all this, or
just noticing that you kind of have an attraction to younger like that.
I don't know.
Has it been like since high school? If it has, it has. It's okay.
No, it shouldn't be high school. I think it's when I had got myself first used like that.
Oh, so it was earlier?
Like when I was a child, yeah.
Okay. So did you kind of notice like the age you were attracted to stayed the same and you kept getting older and older?
I think, I'm not for sure. And well, my question is, would I be in the list if this happens?
Well, I mean, we're both smart guys, dude. You may, you know, you're not dumb. I'm not stupid. Mm-hmm. I mean, the chats say what they say.
I'm trying to clarify, because I know I need therapy and shit.
I don't have the power to put you on any registry, dude, okay? Do I think I have the power to help you? Yeah, absolutely. I don't have the power to arrest you, put you on any registry. This is all voluntary, dude. But in the end, we both know what these say, and, you know, It's not stupid. You're not stupid. We have them all saved, you know. But there are some people that do need trouble. Like, do I think a 50-year-old, 6-year-old needs to go to focus therapy, right?
Right.
I mean,
we're not, like, this is different, but it's, I think it's the same.
Right. Right. So I'm giving you a chance to kind of separate yourself from the true pieces of shit. Because I don't think you're an evil guy at all, man. You're someone that just needs help. So, I mean, let's... So I'm going to ask again, like, do you think it was, did the age you're attracted to kind of stay the same as you get older?
Possibly, I'm not for sure.
I mean,
I think it's showing, but I don't know mentally at the moment.
You think it's probable?
Probable.
Okay.
But if I can go to therapy, it.
Yeah.
I don't know why. It happened. I need to stop, but I don't know. And this is something I didn't want to share with her, because it's...
Too judgmental.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not here to judge you, man. And I know this is hard to talk about. It's probably... Look, y'all really just got married today at the courthouse, or...?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it's... Look, having your wife walk out on you the first day isn't like, the best thing, obviously, but... look at it on the bright side. I mean, she's not here, okay? This is confidential, all right? This isn't me going to go tell her, like, oh, by the way, you know. It's probably better that she's not here to listen to this shit, so we can just be more honest with each other. Like, I was hoping you were home alone. I don't want to...
Do, like, what happened.
Huh?
Do what just happened.
Say again?
Do what just happened with this.
Yeah, like I wasn't hoping that your wife would just like hear all this shit. I mean, but kind of out of my control at that point. But yeah, I mean, so look, I mean, I'm gonna be just forget Emily forget this Emily for a second. Look, I know she talked about no mutuals, but I know how the whole thing works with the Facebook minors and adults communicating. It's not an accident that you came across her profile, or that you friended her, she friended you. I don't know who friended who. I just know you, but it's not an accident. I mean, you were either looking at teen groups. I think that's probable. That's probably the most likely thing, how you came across her thing. Looking at teen groups, looking at bikini pics of minors. I don't know which one it was, but it's one of those, isn't it?
Possibly. It could be, because there's a lot of things that happen on Facebook.
You just look at your feed, and it just keeps getting younger and younger.
I think that's what happened.
Okay. So how many years ago did that start for you on Facebook?
I can't recall. Probably years ago. But at the same time, I tried to stop doing that. And somehow it just...
Oh, yeah. No, believe me. If I didn't think you would stop doing this, I wouldn't be here right now.
Right.
So we can just clear that up, man. So this was... How many years are we talking? Like 10 years ago?
Roughly.
Okay.
Because I... Dunner started Facebook roughly 2016.
Oh, so like 7 years ago?
Roughly 7 to 10 years.
Okay. Were you on anything before Facebook?
No.
Okay. So when your Facebook started, is that kind of when the underage curiosity started?
It really didn't start there. I never had underage curiosity at that time.
Mm-hmm.
It just Facebook.
Kind of sucked you into the rabbit hole?
Yeah.
Okay, so when on Facebook did it start for you? Like a year later, or?
Probably 2 years.
Okay, so basically for 5 years this has been going on.
I don't know if it's 5 years, but I know people was like, oh, do this, do that, do this, do that.
Like, well, do what, do what, do what?
She kept on telling me it's okay, you're not going to get caught because Facebook's whatever.
Oh, so I'm thinking when they say you're not going to get caught, is this an underage person telling you that or a fellow adult?
Adults.
Okay, so they're probably sending you some images, huh?
Was, but then I blocked them and tried to...
Okay. Are these images... I think I know what it is, but you can tell me.
I deleted them, just to let you know.
Okay, I believe that, but you can tell me what they were.
They were just kids. No.
How many were enclosed versus how many... Give me the percentages.
There was none, though, at that time.
So when did that start?
Good question. Very good question, to be honest.
Thanks. I'm just kidding. Yeah, you tell me.
Probably, because I didn't know at the time I was being wrong. It was just... I'm lost in thought right now because it's going.
Gather, bro. I know. It's a lot. It's a lot of years just coming out right now, bro. I understand. Hey, man. Let this be the worst and best day of your life, okay?
It's going to stay worse with that. That's the problem.
Well, one at a time. One Emily at a time here, Shane.
Yeah.
Yeah, my fault.
You're good.
See, that's why I filmed, because you told someone we broke in. Yeah.
I think after, like, after getting that and then the age thing, I think it became an obsession when I could do it, but I'm not for sure on that until I get more thoughts better.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. When you could.
Be able to do it myself, because I never had access to internet or anything when I was a child. So I couldn't really understand what's going on.
When they would send you some images? Or?
Yeah.
Okay. So... Basically, 2018, the bikini pics started coming in.
And everything else started to fall apart after that.
Did it basically go from, you know, raunchy bikini pics of kids to straight up just...
It was kids and adults.
Okay. Did it start to turn more into kids?
It was more adults first.
Okay.
With bikinis.
Right. Yeah, 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 sure.
And then I kept on getting belittled on Facebook, and I was like...
Belittled?
Yeah.
What do you mean? Like...
Females kept on belittling me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And then I was like, I didn't know how to feel about myself. And I still didn't know how to, if that makes sense.
Okay. So do you think that it was because the underage was more understanding of you?
I think.
Okay.
I think.
So let's kind of do one at a time here. So it started with bikini pics of adults to bikini pics of kids. So when did it start to get into, you mentioned you deleted it, which is great, but when did it get to the territory of like straight up of kids?
A few months after that.
So we're still in 2018 at this point.
And it's just, I've been trying to, after that, 2017 is when it started.
Okay.
I just tried to stay away from it.
So basically, like, so is it fair to say you've been trying to kind of dipping your toes in and out of child?
No, trying to stay away from it all.
Trying to stay away from it all?
Yeah, because I knew it wasn't right.
Right.
At the time.
Okay.
And then after all that, this.
So how many times, do you think they, so would you only get sent child on Facebook or would it be on other apps too?
Facebook.
Only on Facebook?
For now, yes.
For now? Or when did it start to turn into other apps?
It wasn't other apps.
Okay.
This for now, because I didn't want to, and I'm going to, like she said, I'm going to delete everything.
Who would send that child to you on Facebook?
I don't know. That's the mystery. Because, you know, people can make fake accounts.
Hmm. So how young did it go? Did it go as young as, like, because I know some of those, I know, I'm, you know, maybe if you don't even ask for it, but did it go as young as infants in some of them? No. Toddlers? Seven, eight?
This.
Like 11-year-olds? Mm-hmm. Okay.
I try to stay there.
Uh-huh.
But at the same time, I'm like, no, I need to stop.
Mentally. Right, right.
I'm fighting that mental war there.
Will they send you videos and pictures? Or?
There was a few that did.
Uh-huh.
And then I said no. I tried to, and then this happened.
What were the videos of? Like,
yeah, all of them.
Like little girls and sex? Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. Were they with an adult in those videos?
No.
They were just kind of like themselves or something?
Yeah, and then I tried to, no, I needed.
Okay, so did you mostly get pictures or videos?
Both.
So it was a comp, like 50-50? Okay, how many are we talking here? Like in the millions?
No, just like 4 or 5, and then I tried to.
Okay.
I kept on blocking them.
Well, slow down. I don't think over the course of 5 years you've only been sent 5 images of that.
Because of the fact I kept on blocking them, that's why.
Yeah, but it was had to be multiple guys. Look, I'm not saying that you didn't block them, mm-hmm. but when it comes to them sending stuff like that, it's a never-ending waterfall. Okay.
That's why I've been constantly trying to.
Right.
Because I don't want to be. I'm trying to get out of that mindset, and this just proves that I'm not fully out of it.
Yeah. Well, I kind of want to get a background before we get into this. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think the amount of videos and pictures you received of basically child, did you ever distribute any?
I tried not to? Tried not to because I knew that was wrong.
Okay. Well, how many times did you, like, slip up and distribute some yourself?
Only of hers, that's all.
Of her as a kid?
No, of her right now. As an adult, that's only it.
Well, how many times did you send around child?
None.
Okay. So you never would send it?
No.
Okay, you would just receive it a couple. Okay. So I know it wasn't 5 times. It had to be at least hundreds of times.
Because of multiple people.
Yeah. So was it hundreds of times?
Probably.
Okay.
Like I said, I kept on losing track. That's why I kept
on
reading.
So it was too many to count. Mm. Okay. So do you remember, like, how long the videos were?
A few seconds to a minute.
Okay. Okay. So, I mean, if you're telling me that, that means you had to watch them.
And that's why I was like...
So you'd have a lot of guilt after?
Yes,
okay.
Because of that. That's why I'm trying.
Okay. So it wasn't always a block. It was kind of get your d*** and then block.
I guess.
Well, you guess. I mean, if you know how long the videos are.
I feel pathetic now.
Yeah, I know. We should get you some help, man.
What can I do? Besides therapy, what can I do?
Control yourself. Literally, you wouldn't need any therapy if you could control yourself, but I don't know if you can right now.
Right now, I don't know. That's what I'm asking.
Right. Right. I agree. We can stay in touch. That's what we're going to have to do. But I know you don't want to be like this, Shane.
I know I don't. It's that hard. In touch would be nice.
A what?
In touch would be nice.
Okay. Good, man. Take your time, bro. Dude, the fact that you're having this reaction tells me that you actually want to change.
And I don't think my wife would ever accept me for this.
I can vouch for you. Be your wingman, G. Jesus Christ. Am I get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey.
Hey, how's it going?
PD, looking for Gordon?
Oh, that's, oh, let me, that's me right there.
That's you?
Okay. I guess, did Emily call, or?
I'm not for sure who called is.
Wasn't us.
What's your name, sir?
Shane. I'm
Shane?
Right here. They're here to help me.
Okay. What's going on?
Well,
first off, who is everybody?
Oh, my name's Alex.
You're Alex?
Yeah,
Gordon.
Yeah, Gordon.
Gordon.
Yeah,
and, no. you're Emily? Is that your wife?
No, it's my wife.
Yeah, I guess Emily Emily called her. It's in my car, but.
Okay. So, what is this?
Well, basically.
Therapy stuff.
Well, basically, we're posing as underage kids online, and. He's kind of texting one. We're just kind of talking to him about that.
He's texting one?
Yeah, yeah. Just kind of, we're posing as a minor online, and,
Okay. Alright. So, do you guys have, alright, will you step out here with
him? Yeah, yeah.
And talk with him? You hear what's going on?
Can we get your
okay.
Affirmative.
Prayer.
You guys are from out of town?
Yes, Texas.
Houston, Texas.
Houston, Texas.
Yes, sir. Well, okay. All three of us.
Okay. And you've never met them until today?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, well, I believe the one is yours is always able to either talk to a minor, so.
Alfredo, what's the phone number for you? Is it Pablo?
Sorry.
What's a phone number for you? And was anybody else here at the home when you guys got here?
Oh, his wife.
She said she was going to go to her dad's house.
Go ahead. What time did you guys get here?
40 minutes ago.
Not 40 minutes. Okay. Sorry. Probably been like what, probably 5:40.
Yes, sir.
I would be his wife, Emily.
17:40. Where you guys staying at?
Yeah,
we were just passing through because we do this nationwide, so we travel all around. So we're just passing through.
Okay. Where you guys staying at tonight, though?
At a hotel.
Columbia.
Okay. All right. Are these all good addresses for you guys?
Yes, sir.
Hey, are you cool with these two coming out and I'll talk with Shane? They're being cooperative. I don't think there's a whole lot. I'll have you guys step out and I'll talk to
someone. You got the information and everything?
Yeah, I've got their IDs.
Basically, we just overheard the cops say that Shane told them that he thinks it's because he got hacked. This is just, it shows you, no matter how much they cry. Let me just tell you, when I say in the videos they need help, I don't actually mean it. They all need to be in jail. That just shows you, no matter how much, they're all manipulative scumbags. Oh, police presence. We're not going to visit Wichita Falls this time because we have this. All right, we're at the Wichita Falls police station. Does that say police right there?
Yes.
Okay, and Wichita Falls police, so is that a badge?
It looks like it.
So is it fair to say that's law enforcement presence in the video?
It says 911.
Yep, yeah, absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. So, yes sir, we're here to turn this in right here, okay? We're turning in evidence of a potential crime that was committed, and we're doing it with the police right here, okay? Just let me know when that gets to a minute and 10 seconds so we can just make sure it's in the video. Oh, does it say police headquarters right there?
It does.
So that's in this video though, right? So is that not police presence?
Oh, there's another one over there.
Really? Let's go look at it. Wow. Look at all the police presence right there. I mean, that's law enforcement, isn't it? And do we say cops are part of law enforcement? No, they're not.
Oh.
Oh, do you work for YouTube? I'd say cops are part of law enforcement.
Yeah, okay.
Two to one. So that therefore that's law enforcement presence. That's in line with YouTube's TOS. So anyway, please sub to Rumble and join us on Local so we don't have to do this ridiculous stuff anymore. I'm sick of using this platform. My God, sub to Rumble in the pinned comment. We're gonna go turn it in actually now.
Zoom in on it. Rafilos. Filos, guys.
Are those all law enforcement officers? And they're in the video?
Yep.
Oh, wow.
I think they're all just fascists.
Yeah. Remember, we gotta put them in the video, but we also have to say they're bad.
What about this for these like police badges?
I think so.
These are Nazi signs.
Wow. Okay, for you.
Okay.
When the cop comes, just fill the Easter egg. We're talking about the country posing as like minors online, and online predators message us from across the country. We're from Houston, but we just travel all over doing this. And there was an individual by the name of messaging us, who he believed to be a 13-year-old girl. He said he wants to have a threesome with her and her friend and get a hotel room. He never followed through with that, but he was just buried as the messages. And he said he's talked to other minors online before, and he said that he's on this app called Telegram where he's receiving links to what seemed to be buying pictures of minors and stuff like that. But that's all he would say about Telegram. But we interviewed him at his home, and he admitted to sending all of these messages that were like in nature to be following this kid. And yeah, I just want to turn it over to my mom.
Hey, you see that? That's our first international arrest in Canada. Oh, you see that? That's our arrest in our 42nd state, Delaware. YouTube's censoring channels like this left and right. If you want to keep this movement alive, consider joining Locals in the pinned comment. You can see all of these uncensored, no filter, for only $7 a month. And you can keep this movement alive in spite big tech. Choice is yours. You can support the group that has an arrest in 42 different states in 2 countries. You can see catches like the fire lieutenant, which I can't post publicly until after his trial. You can see all of Stinghouse content that I think is too spicy for here, plus much, much more. Contribute directly to getting these people off the streets. Keep yourself entertained. Keep us going. Join Locals. Pin comment.